Morning, guys. We're out here on this frozen tundra. Wonderland. -6 degrees this morning. I'm about to smack up some gills for you. Stay tuned.
Well, it's been out far enough. That's what I probably did. I done probably got it too far bent out. And my reel's about froze shut.
That's a baby crappie.
There he is.
Oh, spiky.
We was at the other day, we kept 100 of them fuckers like that, 12 inches.
Yeah.
They want another 100 taken out of there.
Really?
Yeah.
Up at Charlie's Pond?
Yep. It didn't matter what color I put down, I was like the freaking bass catching fool.
Here we go, come on.
Ready.
That's a good fish.
You'll catch a lot of them.
Oh yeah. Decent bluegill.
See that red ear I caught at Charlie's?
Uh-huh.
It was 13¼ inches, and it was almost 5 inches tall.
You know, I caught one for over 14 inches down at Guy's, don't you?
Yeah.
We've heard of 16.
Well, these little bluegills fight pretty good.
Yeah, they do.
They're skinny little guys, too.
This one's scrapping.
Fish up high, what are these, crappie?
I don't know. Might mark the fish up high. Uh-oh.
What do you got?
I don't know.
There's a crappie. Good one?
Better one.
Well, whatever's up high, it's probably a spike going down because it ain't stopping.
Yeah, all the fish, I mean, every fish, I never marked the fish high yesterday. Every fish is 3 foot off the bottom and on the bottom.
Holy shit.
Hey, I got a crappie. Nope, it's not a crappie. That's what I use, a spoon.
Well, I use sharpen one end, edge of it. Not too sharp, you know, just get a nice little edge on it.
The other one, guys, tearing them up.
I went off the left of the backpack, just got my bag. God bless it. There's a guy in Tennessee that's coming out with a bloodworm paste for trapping fishing. Yeah.
That'd be good perch fishing.
I might have to order some.
Yeah.
go the other way.
I feel like I'm fishing a spear lake. This is all he catches, spear lake.
That fish didn't want, he didn't want to swim back down. He wanted to swim back up.
They come up for it as it's going down. They don't even have, I don't even got to get to the bottom.
Oh, I know. It's stupid.
Ooh. You let go of it. That's a little bit better one there. These fish must not eat very much. They're skinny.
It'd be nice if these fish were all about a quarter inch thicker. Maybe I shouldn't do that.
Just
I went to get the ice off the end of my rod, my tongue stuck to the end of my rod.
Oh yeah.
It's all them pictures you posted, honey.
I don't post no fucking pictures, because I know better. Hey, look what I caught on a private pond.
You wouldn't believe how many people messaged me asking me where I'm fishing at. Have any luck over there, Mr. King? I'd come out to this edge. There's one right behind him. I'd hit it. I had to move away from there, come out this way. I've already filled up the bottom of my bucket.
about 4 feet high and letting them come to it.
Yep.
Oh, that was a big one. Oh, that felt good. I done fucked up on that one. That seems to be getting a little bit better fish. Staying up a little higher.
Drop it down to the bottom and reel it just slowly off the bottom again.
Well, and then I catch some little fucks. I put three on the ice since I put three
on the fire. He's feisty. He's a little bit small. Let me throw him in the hole. Oh, go back down. There you go. You know the routine.
I'll load up my bug with about three spikes and see what that does. Call it a spike this year. All beam logs? Oh, just a little piece of plastic?
Yeah.
That's probably not a bad idea. I could switch to... I got a tungsten bug on another rod. I could do that on another rod.
Not a bad one.
What you want that rod tip to do?
Oh, that was a good one.
Why'd you lose him?
Because I'm not fast enough to pull my vessel out of the
hole. That's why I do all those back fucking holes.
No, I got mine just underneath the eye.
Hold fine. Hold still. I'll let you go. Hold on. Nice gill. Here's what I'm doing, guys. This little black bug, tip of the spike. I'm running a dock runner. Ugly stick, you know me and my ugly sticks. Gotta have an ugly stick. Tie a spring bob around the end of it. Sealed it up nice. They just touched that. Fish will fart on it, you'll see it.
Did he? He did?
Missed him. Nailed it. I'll come back. There he is. All hand size.
It's gonna drive me nuts. I let someone else use this rod the other day and the reel's on the wrong fucking side. Have you ever heard of ASO line? When I bought my Vexlar, they had some Chinese freaking fluorocarbon. I was like, I'll try that. It's 1 pound test, but it's supposed to be equal to 2.4 pound line.
Is that right?
That's what it says. There, I caught a crappie.
Do you like it?
So far, I do. It's pretty tough line.
Dang.
For one, supposed to be 1 pound test.
Keep missing, fellas. They're sensitive.
Caught a little crappie. The crappie man caught a crappie.
On that plastic?
Yep. Dude, I caught a bunch of them on this at Salmo the other day. They like this plastic.
Down the hole. Got them that time. You can get them right. He's fighter. Oh yeah, look at that. That's a good one.
Amazing how much faster the pumps are at the bottom, isn't it?
Oh yeah.
That was a shame, man. Dude, got him fired up again, by golly.
One after the other. Gloves are starting to get wet. I think I brought an extra pair.
$80 worth of tungsten, but Brad or Gaff the other day. Yeah. He's like, you like them tungsten, don't you? I said, yep. He goes, I'll make you a deal on those. So he made me a deal. I couldn't turn down.
Mister.
There tomorrow. He was working on a rod the other day and I made him make it a little bit longer than he wanted to, and I think it's going to be a good rod. What's that?
He's getting more crunchy.
Oh, is he?
Yeah.
Dude, I tell you what, I've had three or four people offer some pretty good money for this rod.
What is it, a trumpinator?
Yeah.
It's just a noodle rod. It's got crunk on it. Red, white, and blue.
It's actually a pretty damn nice rock.
Oh, that's a better fish. Unless he's just fighting. He's just fighting. He fought harder than the bigger ones in there.
Tungsten gets to the bottom a whole lot faster.
Why use it instead of a fucking wire bag?
God.
Hey.
When I can't use a bait, I'm flipping a plastic. And I had no problem doing that.
Drop it down to the bottom. Bring it up about a foot. Just barely move it. The lighter you move it, the better.
I just threw one back because I just been in the habit of throwing them back. That was probably a good fish when it bounced.
Oh. Lost him. That fish will live to see another day, huh? A nice crappie.
Oh, yeah.
Yep. Black crappie, look like.
Yeah, the red ears. You only allowed 25 of them.
Yeah. That's a good one.
That's why they want to do that 25 aggregate, because people can't tell the difference between them. When I was at a coon lake over there at the Barbie chain that one day, that CEO thought he was going to get me. One more, because I was raping a bed of the big blue red ear. I had 106 bluegill and 24 red ears.
Really?
I stopped at 24 on purpose. And I had them separated. He goes, I bet you there's a red ear in them. Huh?
You know, we need to go back over and chase him first.
Where?
At coon.
Yeah, we could do that. Yep.
All I got was dinks last year. I never could find any good ones.
I got a secret little hole over there.
My God. That I couldn't get out before.
We need to go to freaking Loon Lake. We whacked some good perch there last year. That one about jerked the frickin' rod on me. I don't miss that fish.
There we go. Crappy.
Taking the grandkids to fire.
Barely hooked him. All right, guys, we tore him up for you. Thanks for watching. God bless.